All right, Kim, I'll let you know when to start. All right, go ahead and start.
Good evening, and welcome to tonight's United Food and Commercial Workers Telephone Town Hall with Congressman Bruce Braley. Tonight, we'll be talking about the upcoming Senate election here in Iowa. And after the Congressman speaks, we'll open the floor to questions. At any time, you can press 0 on your phone to ask a question, and you'll be connected directly with one of our volunteer operators. Thanks for joining tonight to all of our UFCW members across Iowa and to our special guest, Congressman Bruce Braley. As workers, we have seen the attacks from around the country. And even right here in Iowa, out-of-state billionaires are trying to buy this election by throwing their weight behind Joni Ernst, because they know this race has implications far beyond the state of Iowa. It's a good chance that the winner of this race will determine control of the United States Senate. We have a chance to stop that, to stop a national right-to-work fight, by standing up and supporting Bruce Braley, someone who has always fought for workers, and who will keep fighting for us in D.C. Please join me in welcoming Congressman Bruce Braley to our call. Thanks for being here, Congressman.
Thank you, Kim. And I want to thank everyone on the USCW leadership team, Jerry, Leo, Marv, Jim, and Roger. And most importantly, I want to thank all of you on the call tonight for what you do every day fighting for working Iowans. I am honored and proud that USCW members have supported me in all of my elections, and I've worked hard to be a strong voice in the U.S. House of Representatives for members who want to make sure that the economy works for everyone, not just the wealthy few. And that's why I'm running for the Senate, because I want to make sure working Iowans have a shot at providing for their families and living the American dream. That's what I learned growing up in Brooklyn, Iowa. My dad ran a grain elevator. He came home from the war, served in the Marine Corps on Iwo Jima. And when I was 2 years old, I learned a valuable lesson about workplace safety. My dad fell 30 feet at that grain elevator he was managing and shattered his right leg. And he was laid up for almost a year. And if it hadn't been for the safety net of workers' compensation benefits and a lot of family and friends who helped take care of us, we wouldn't have made it. My mom was a school teacher, but she had left the workforce and was raising a family of four kids when my dad had his accident. He couldn't do that job anymore because after he got healed up, he walked with a big lift in his shoe and a severe limp the rest of his life. And he had to change his jobs because of that workplace injury. My mom decided she was going to go back to school and get a 4-year teaching degree to help take care of our family. And she ended up driving 26,000 miles to get her teaching degree, went back in the classroom. She's 85 years old, and she's still working as a substitute teacher in my hometown of Brooklyn. So I learned from my parents the value of hard work. And that's why I got my first job in third grade delivering the Des Moines Tribune. And I've been working ever since. And if you can name a kind of job you could get in rural Iowa, I probably had it. I did farm work when I was in junior high. I was a janitor and a painter when I was in high school. I ended up doing construction work for about 5 years. I did a lot of truck driving, and I was a bartender, a janitor, a waiter, a cook, and a dishwasher. Each one of those jobs taught me something important. They taught me the importance of an honest day's work for an honest day's pay. And that's why I've been a strong voice for working people who want to get up and provide for their families. That's why I was proud to walk onto the floor as the first member to speak the day that we passed the Employee Free Choice Act in the House of Representatives. That's why I'm leading the fight to raise the minimum wage to $10.10 an hour. And I did that because it would give 300,000 Iowans a pay raise. That's 20% of the workforce in Iowa. 180,000 of those Iowans are women. Nearly half of them are over the age of 30. And about 100,000 of them have children. I believe that raising the minimum wage is the right thing to do because it'll give all those Iowans a pay raise. Joni Ernst not only won't raise the minimum wage, she doesn't even think we need a federal minimum wage. She's called it ridiculous. What I think is ridiculous is that a hardworking Iowan could be working 40 hours a week in a minimum wage job, making $15,000 a year and living in poverty. And that's why I'm going to be working hard to make sure that that happens. I'm also going to work to strengthen retirement security by protecting Social Security and Medicare. I think if you're a millionaire or a billionaire, you should be paying the same share of your earned income into Social Security that hardworking Iowans do. And it will strengthen the Social Security Trust Fund, and it will provide greater benefits to people when they retire. I've been paying into Social Security and Medicare for 40 years, and I want them to be there for my children and my grandchildren. I also support a strong workplace safety environment because I know why it's important from what happened to my dad. And I've spent my whole life fighting to make sure we have safer workplace conditions. So that's why I'm on this call tonight. I'm running for the Senate to make sure that Iowa's working families have the same opportunities I did to lift themselves up and live the American dream. And I think that the economy that works for Iowa is an economy that gives everyone that chance. And that means more jobs with a livable wage, not just a minimum wage. But I need your help. We have 15 days until the election. Iowans are voting right now. They've been voting until September 25th. And with your help, we're going to win this election. It's a very close race. I've had $20 million of outside secret money spent against me. A lot of that money has been spent telling lies about who I am and about what my record is all about. And I need you to get out the truth. Every door you knock between now and November 4th, every phone call that you make, every absentee ballot that you get turned in helps me get one vote closer to being your next senator. I am proud to be your friend. I am proud of the hard work that you do every day and your hard-earned contributions that have helped me win in the past. I know how to win tough races. I've done it before. That's why we're going to win on November 4th, but we have to work every minute between now and 9 o'clock when the polls close, and that's why I wanted to join you for this call. So I look forward to your questions, and I appreciate your support. Kim?
Thank you so much, Congressman. Just want to remind everybody on the line that you can press 0 at any time to ask a question. We've got some operators standing by to get those for you. So just press 0 to ask Congressman Braley a call. While we're waiting for a question, we're going to start with a quick poll for everyone on the phone. I think this is an easy question. If the election were held today, who would you vote for? To all of our listeners, please press 1 if you would vote for Bruce Braley. Press 2 if you would vote for Joni Ernst. Press 3 if you are undecided and would like more information on the election. And remember, you can press 0 at any time to ask a question. So if the election were held today, who would you vote for? 1 for Bruce Braley, 2 for Joni Ernst, or 3 if you are undecided? Okay. And while the polls are ticking away there for Bruce Braley, we're going to go to our first question. And our friend Tim has to ask, what role does a strong labor movement play in growing the middle class, and how can you help it do that?
It's Tim, right, Kim?
Tim, yes.
Okay, great question. When I got to Congress, one of the things that I did was I founded the Populist Caucus, which had originally been founded by Tom Harkin, but had been disbanded. And the whole purpose was to fight for economic policies that were going to strengthen and expand the middle class, because we know that our country has always been at its strongest when there is a growing middle class, and people know they have a chance to live the middle class dream. The labor movement has been absolutely critical in giving us the minimum wage. in giving us the 40-hour work week, in giving us child labor laws that protect us and stronger workplace safety rules like OSHA. We know that most of the major advances that have strengthened the middle class were strongly supported and many of them initiated by labor movement. That's why I have been proud to work with my friends in labor to fight for economic justice and fairness and to make sure that we stand up to these powerful special interests, millionaires and billionaires who are bombing the airwaves with misleading information about who I am and what I stand for. So let's take something as simple as standing up for veterans. I have introduced legislation with Republican co-sponsors that got passed into law to give employers tax credits to hire veterans, including disabled veterans. And because of those efforts, veterans are getting hired by employers all over the country, including Iowa, with those tax credits. And I think that's important to do because so many veterans are part of the labor movement and have been part of supporting me, and that's why I want to support them.
Great. Thank you so much. We've got a question from Ryan coming in as well. So I think it may be Brian. 1 second. We'll get Brian live on here. All right, Brian?
Yes.
All right, Brian in Ottumwa has a question for you, Congressman.
Hey, Brian.
Okay, I was wondering what the biggest difference was between Ernst and workers' rights.
Brian was breaking up just a little bit, and if somebody could repeat the question, I would be happy to answer it.
He asked what the biggest difference between you and Joni Ernst were on workers' rights.
Yeah, I support the rights of workers to organize in the workplace. And Senator Ernst would go to Washington and be a senator who would work to promote an agenda that would take away workers' rights, their rights to organize, their rights to collectively bargain, and their rights to provide greater protection in the workplace. I don't think there's any question on that. And I think that she's been strongly supported by right-to-work organizations, and that their agenda is to continually work to reduce and eventually eliminate people's rights to organize and protect themselves in the workplace.
Great. Thanks for your question, Brian. Just a reminder to everybody else on the line, you can ask a question at any time by pressing zero. While we're waiting for another question, we'd like to ask one more question of our listeners tonight. We want to know what you're willing to do to help Bruce Braley win in November. Press 1 if you will volunteer. Press 2 if you will vote early or if you already have voted. Press 3 if you will talk to friends and family. And press 4 if you will do all of these. And once again, press 0 at any time to ask a question. But what can you do to help Bruce Braley in November? Press 1 to volunteer. Press 2 if you have or promise to vote early. Press 3 if you'll talk to friends and family. And press 4 if you'll do all of these. And then we've got Will on the line as well for a question.
Hi, Will.
Hi. I was just wondering about, you know, what you would do, Congressman, about how much money there is in politics right now.
Well, that's another huge difference between Senator Ernst and me, and it came out during the last two debates we have. I'm the only candidate who voted to restrict the influence of secret donors that are filling up Iowa's airwaves with $20 million of negative attack ads against me. And I voted for the Disclose Act because I think that if you're going to be spending money in elections, people have a right to know who you are and what you're spending your money on and who is joining you to pay for those attack ads. And Senator Ernst made it very clear that she thinks secret donors have greater political free speech than working Iowans do. Because if I spend any money on a political ad, I have to disclose every one of my donors, and I have to file reports regularly that identify what I'm spending it on. You won't know who the donors are paying for all these outside attack ads against me, and you won't know for a long time how much money they spent because they don't have to file reports on the same regular basis we do. That's why I will continue to stand up for meaningful campaign finance reform to give working Iowans the same voice in elections that big out-of-state secret donors have.
Great answer. We appreciate that. Just a reminder for everybody that you can press zero to ask a question at any time. And thanks to all those folks who are willing to volunteer. We'll be making sure we get in touch with you very soon. Meanwhile, we've got we had a very similar question to the money in politics. So we're going to go back to something you touched on briefly. And what's the best thing that you can do to keep Social Security solvent for us when we retire?
That's a great question. And once again, the differences between Joni Ernst and Bruce Braley could not be more different. I think Social Security is based on a solemn promise that the government makes. You work hard, you pay to Social Security, it's going to be there for you when you need it. And Senator Ernst has made it clear she supports Social Security for people like her parents and my parents who are using and drawing on those benefits that they earned after years of paying into it. But she has also made it clear that she will support privatizing Social Security for other workers. I've been paying into Social Security for 40 years. I want it to be there for my kids and my grandchildren. That's why I will never vote to privatize Social Security. That's not a retirement plan for hardworking Iowans. That's a retirement plan for investment bankers on Wall Street. And so what I would do is I would strengthen and protect Social Security, because I think if you're a millionaire or a billionaire, you should be paying the same share of your earned income into the Social Security Trust Fund as hardworking Iowans do, and that's not the case right now. That would really strengthen the Social Security Trust Fund for years to come. It would actually allow us to increase benefits for Iowa seniors by changing the cost of living adjustment formula to be more reflective of the true cost of seniors who depend on those benefits. But I also think that raising the minimum wage will help strengthen the Social Security Trust Fund, because it will pump billions of additional money into the Social Security Trust Fund every year, and that's good for Iowa seniors.
Great. Thanks so much. Just a quick check back on some of our poll results. If the election were held today, we have 73% of you saying you'd vote for Bruce Braley, 20% that are undecided, and right now we've got 6% for Joni Ernst. So that's a poll result that we wanted to share with everybody on the phone. And we've got a question coming from Kevin, but just a reminder that everybody can press zero to ask a question at any time. So now we're going to go to Kevin from Osceola. Kevin,
Hi, I'm here.
Great.
Yes,
Kevin, you're on live with Congressman Bruce Braley.
Thank you for taking my call. I am a mental health consumer, and I wonder what Mr. Braley's stance is on the disabled and mental health issues in particular. Thank you.
Well, Kevin, this is very personal to me, because my father landed on Iwo Jima when he was an 18-year-old Marine, the day that they raised the flags on Mount Suribachi, and he brought home some of the emotional scars of that combat. And when I was growing up, I saw him struggle with two severe bouts of depression. So I know how important mental health treatment is. And quite frankly, we've done a lousy job in this country of living up to our commitment to providing quality, locally available mental health treatment to millions of Americans. That's why the largest mental health treatment facility in the United States is the Los Angeles County Jail. I've worked hard for mental health parity in Congress, and I've also worked hard to remove the stigma of mental health treatment because I saw it with my own eyes and my own family. And I know that we need to make sure that people who are struggling with mental illness have access to the care that they need. And that's why I supported mental health parity, because I believe that it's important that we provide locally available mental health treatment to people so that they could get treatment, diagnosis, and help them cope with their illness and become productive, active members of society, which is possible with the right treatment program.
Great. Thanks so much for your question, Kevin. Want to remind
Thanks,
everybody,
Kevin.
You can press zero to ask any questions. We're getting close to wrapping it up because we want to make sure that we keep the congressman on his schedule so we can get out every single vote possible. So the one question that just came up is, what about investing in infrastructure across Iowa, and what can you do to help in creating jobs?
As someone who worked 4 summers in construction, including on a bridge crew in Pawshee County, this is something that is very important to me because we have failed to meet our infrastructure needs. And we, according to the American Society of Civil Engineers, we have trillions of dollars of backed up infrastructure needs that we need to address. We also know.
Oh, I think we are breaking up a little bit there, Congressman. Well, we may have lost the Congressman due to cell phone service, but before everyone gets off the line, I want to kick it over to Jerry Messer, who has a few thoughts on the election and has been around the state for a long time working in politics. Jerry?
Thank you, Kim. I just like to add that also this is probably one of the most important elections that that we've ever had, and it's very important to vote. Bruce has got a 97% voting record for working families. He has definitely earned our support. There's a lot of different ways we can also help him. Add that 73% people supporting him by reaching out to our families, our friends, and encourage them and to go vote. And Joni had a 13% working family record in the Senate. She definitely is no friend of ours. You know, she brags about castrating hogs on the farm, but I can tell you she'd like to take that skill to Washington, D.C., and castrate workers also. So let's put a stop to this. Get out and vote on Election Day. Volunteer. And if anybody's got any questions, willing to answer them.
Well, and I think with that great introduction, Jerry, I think we're going to kick it back to everybody on the volunteer question. And for everybody that's still on the phone and still fighting for Bruce Braley, what are you willing to do to help Bruce Braley in November? Press 1 if you're willing to volunteer. Press 2 if you're willing to vote early. Press 3 if you're willing to talk to friends and family. And press 4 if you're willing to do all of those. Again, that's 1 to volunteer, 2 to vote early, and 3 to talk to friends and family, and 4 if you'll do all of those. Well, while those are coming in, just want to, if you have any questions for Jerry or myself, you can press 0. Otherwise, you'll have an opportunity to leave a voicemail after the call. I really appreciate everyone joining us from around the state of Iowa. This is a crucial election, not just for Iowa, but for the whole country. And for all the folks who have been out there knocking doors, voting, talking to your friends and family, we've only got 15 days left, and If you're tired of the phone calls, if you're tired of the door knocks, the fastest way to get off the list is to get out there and vote, because they're not going to keep contacting you. So thank you all for your time, and let's go out there and fight hard the next 15 days. Thanks so much for joining us tonight.